I wouldn't even know how to answer this, man. This is one I would have to sit down about, man. I'm not even gonna lie. Fuck.
Like, you know, they don't know the pain I've been through, you know, like what I lost, the friends I lost, you know?
People think I'm all about like violence, but like I actually like fight for peace, you know? I want peace, you know?
Growing up in my hood, you know what I'm saying? I've lost a lot of people. And even the people that are doing bad, sometimes they don't even have a choice. It's very easy to get caught up in the shit. Sometimes shit just gets caught up with you, just being in a place like that. So it's pretty hard still.
I don't want people to go to jail. My dad got life in prison, you know what I mean? I don't want people to do, what I went through, you know? Or what people around me went through. I don't want anybody to go through none of that stuff. I lost friends in these streets too. I don't want to lose more friends to gun violence, you know?
I was on a strict conditions, like house arrest. Then I got sentenced and I got on parole. I couldn't do shows when people wanted to book me.
Nobody want to be out there really shooting guns and really going to jail forever. Because that's what really happens. You know, people really die. Violence is everywhere. So you can never really be too safe.
Well, people that aren't really from the lifestyle, it's easier for them because it's like you're just jumping into something. Like, we have to live it, right?
If you live in a nice area or live in a nice house, like, you need to respect that. You need to thank God for your blessings. You need to, you know, thank your mom, thank your parents.
It's easy to pull a trigger, you know? It's not easy to move your mom out of the hood, you know?
Like, I never had that much as growing up as a kid either, you know? Like, I still have to go and hustle myself to go get money, buy shoes for school and stuff.
There's no one to really talk to about their issues, you know? Other than their other little buddies that are the same age as them and going through the same type of crisis, and that's why it gets crazy.
But in a lot of the situations in the city, passed down by elders, people don't even know about them. People don't even know the logistics of the beef or why or what really happened. It's just, I'm conditioned to hate this area or this group of people.
You know, for example, Smokey, maybe rest in peace, you know what I mean? He was my little cousin, you know, but due to like neighborhood and all this type of stuff, we didn't really connect like how we should have connected. But at the end of the day, he's my relative, you know what I mean? I can still go to his mom. He can come to my mom, you know.
It's dangerous. Something that nobody wants to experience, but you gotta live with it.
Like, I wish we could push a button and, like, everybody that we lost in street life, they're back. But everything that happened that led up to this shit, we could remember. And all the pain and shit that we felt, we could still feel it. And now we have a chance to be like, yo, do we really want to do this shit again?
When it comes to people I lost, I want them to be remembered as people who tried amidst the fact that they didn't have any options, you know?
Like, I want to be remembered as kings, young kings. But like, these guys that I grew up with, like, they might not be the angel, but no one's an angel, right? At the end of the day, but the guys I grew up, they do positive stuff. They breathe and eat just like me. We're all human beings at the end of the day, right?
The people make it look like we're some bad guys. We're not bad guys.
For the people who I lost and how I want them to be remembered, I'm gonna show them.
After my bro died, I was like, yo, I can't stop.
I do this all for this person, you feel what I'm saying? So I have to go hard for that.
Like Illy, Dubs, Payback, even Louis, like, those people, like, they just make sure you were good, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I try to be the same and portray the same things. You lose a physical entity, yeah, but you get like a guiding light, you know what I'm saying? Like, you feel me? So
I know that the circumstances and everything is really messed up, but as far as that part, like, I really do feel like they're like, yeah, they're still here.
I want them to be remembered as people that saw the vision as well. It was to separate themselves from that street politics. and wanted to be artistic and wanted to do this over here, what makes you happy, and being able to talk to thousands and millions of people, you know, your craft, but then you have this side over here and it keeps pulling you back, you know? It's a tug of war, you know?
I like to remember the friends I've lost as great teachers, you know? And I apologize if I ever use their teachings in vain, you know?
Yeah, you gotta just tell everybody at the end of every conversation, every day, that you love them, you know? Life is short, so you just gotta spread love as much as you can.
I don't ever try to, like, glamorize it in an effect where it's like I'm bigging this shit up like it's cool. I'm just trying to tell the story of me trying to go from being that person to try and elevate it now with the music and why I'm taking it, trying to take it serious.
You know that feeling when you get the cuffs put on you, you get put in the back of the car. It's not a game when that happens. You might not come home. This is for real.
Trouble's gonna be around you, like, nonstop, you know what I'm saying? Based off of, like, this is years before us, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're just products of our environment. And if you know that and you can grasp that, just try and be better. Just always try and be better, no matter what's going on around you.
I used to cause my mom a lot of stress, and I didn't want to, and I tried to do everything I could to not give her that burden.
To see that figure that raised you, to see her proud of what you've done, you know what I mean? That makes everybody happy.
Coming up from a low-income neighborhood, just trying to make a way out for them. So everything that I do and everything that I put myself into it is for them.
What makes me respect a man and their idea of respect sometimes is so far off that even to have these conversations, it's a daunting path, you know, to try and be the biggest and baddest from your ends or from your hood or whatever. And it's not to say be some punk, it's not to say you can't rep the people that you know and love and grew up around, but it's just way more impactful if you put forth all that energy into a grind that people remember you and say, like, okay, for this particular community, like, I remember that guy came around, gave us all a chance, you know, was able to help the hood, you know, fed us at times, taught us things at times. Like, those are the people that get the glory stories.
I would want to be remembered as a light from my neighborhood.
Honestly, I just want to be remembered, like, that I actually, like, you know, made it off the rap and stuff, like, you know, don't have to be in the streets no more, just motivate the people around me to, you know, do the right things and stuff.
I'd want them to know there's times I almost ended everything, like they wouldn't ever see me again. And, you know, I had to, just looking at their face, I didn't have enough to do it, you know?
I just want them to remember me by, like, I'm my brother's keeper, like, you know what I mean? I'm always somebody that is gonna be there for the next man, or be there for my sister, be there for my mother, you know what I mean? I wanna be remembered as somebody that left a good mark on them, not just a negative vibe, just something that they can take from and say, you know what, at least he achieved something that we can have, and it's longer than him.
I just wanna be remembered as that guy that creates, like, a legacy where my family and all my loved ones could live off of, and feed all their loved ones and all that stuff behind them, put food on tables. There's no one starving that's really connected to me.
I'll be remembered for, like, the success I make, you know, how I treat my family, you know? Like, you know, how I end up, what I leave for my family would be the best thing that I would want.
I just want to be someone that looked out for all my loved ones, my family, my friends.
Someone that did stuff for the community, did good stuff for the kids, you know?
I put on for my family, my friends. It's like, I just wanted them to know what time it is, where it all started, you know?
I want to remember as someone that gave hope for his community, and, like, that inspired others in this hood to do something that they were scared to do, you know?
When it's all said and done, I want to be remembered as an uplifting person, as a person that always keeps spirits high.
I want you to remember me as the guy that, against all odds, never gave up.
I want to be remembered as a Muslim. I want to be remembered as a believer.
I want to be remembered as selfless. I want to be remembered as a positive person.
Please give me time, 'cause I'm searching for you.
I encourage everybody to lift the weight off of themselves, because until you lift that weight, you don't realize how much you're benching, you know?
I love that I'm able to, love, you know what I mean? Like I feel still, I could still feel something up here.